again there is a dispute problem with the Ram Mandir Trust. They again embroiled themselves into some conflict. Some blame game is on. Whether the members of Ram Mandir Trust are serious about avoiding these disputes? Whether they want a smooth construction of the Ram Mandira? Lord Ram Temple? I don't think so. And if you think deeply on the lines I am thinking, I am going to throw the light, you will agree with me. Namaskar, I am Achar Karthi Krishna from Astrodome.com. Dear friends, first I want to clarify that not as a Hindu, but as an Indian, I am very much elated and happy with the prospects of construction of the Sri Ram Temple. Because Ram is the icon which symbolizes the best virtues a man has. In the whole human history, he was the person who had symbolized all the best virtues, all the best qualities a man can have. The way he handled his life, it may be tragic, it may be happy, but he handled his life in the most mature and profound way. So, I'm happy. But when I observe how the decisions are being taken by the Ram Mandir Trust, and when I am especially observing as a Vastu consultant who is teaching Vastu since last 3 decades, I feel very much depressed. Especially when I heard that Ram Mandir Trust has decided to use red stones of the Bansi Pahadpur mines of Rajasthan, I held my head. What are they doing? And what was the raw reason for my shock? Dear friends, you just observe every house, every structure, every building which has been created in your city or anywhere in your country, in your lane, which is completely in the red color. And see what is happening with them. Whether they are passing peaceful life, or passing through struggles on the continuous basis. I will give you example of red forts of Delhi as well as Agra, how the occupants of these two red forts lived, full of blood, conflicts, deaths. And it will be very disputed, but I want to give an example of a university, the Jawaharlal Nehru University. The whole building, whole structure is created in the red brick stone. How the image is always some conflict with the social norms, everything. I am not saying they are right or wrong, but there is always some conflict. There is no monotony in JNU, but there is always some struggle or conflict with the social norms, established social norms. And just because the red symbolizes the Mars. Mars is the graha of war, planet of war. He is Senapati, the commander of war for the divine gods. Suppose that you are constructing a house and if it is made of red color. And what is the purpose of creating house? This is for solace. This is for comfort. You are doing business. You are running an industry. You are doing so many things. And after completing your war of life in the outside world, you are coming into your house for the solace, for the comfort, for taking rest. But if it is not there, what will happen? It will create problems in your life. So never construct any building in the totally in red color. I can give a lot of examples. I have seen thousands of buildings, not only in India, outside India also. But it happens every time. And especially it is more true if the building or structure or fort, whatever it is, it is near some watery body, some river, some nala, some stream. Especially this is true in all the cities where at the river bed or on the banks of river, if some whole building has been created in red color, there is always a conflict. And this is also true. Why? Just I want to explain why this conflict. Because the water element of the river or stream is in conflict with the fire element of the red color of the building. It creates explosion. So it is never conducive to create a building of red color if the building or the structure is in a city which is on the banks of river, which is true in the case of Ayodhya. It is not that I didn't try to pass on this message to the trust people, but I was informed that they have belief in some Vastu consultant, specific Vastu consultant. I argued that Vastu is a complete science, and there is no question of belief. Beliefs always create problems, especially when it is not based on the logic. Some particular senior person, functionary of the trust, has belief in someone, about in the knowledge of someone, then what should I do? I retracted. But when again allegations are coming, conflicts are coming, I tried to convey my sentiments, my knowledge, my exposure towards this. Actually, what happens, red building is not always bad. Many a time, I have personally suggested red buildings, especially for industries, when I need a lot of fire element in the structure of building. But whether we need this fire element in this temple, Sri Ram temple, you may need so. And I know that I am on a social platform and I am recording this YouTube video, and it may be a very disputed statement, but whether the persons who are behind the construction of this temple want to inject some fire element in the Hindu community with this temple, they might be thinking like this. Because it may inject the fire element into the whole community which is going to worship in this temple. But in that case, you will have to balance and harmonize the whole fire element which is the temple is going to generate. Even thoughts of creating temple in the red element, red color, is creating a lot of fire element. But as per my knowledge, nothing has been done to harmonize or settle the fire element in a creative mode which this temple is going to create. So I believe so, and probably rightfully so, that this is the all ignorance. Due to ignorance of the persons who are taking major decisions about the color, structure and shape of this old Ram temple, more and more disputes may come in the path of Ram Mandir construction. And even after the construction of this temple, why are you throwing thorns in the path of the construction of this temple? Why are you creating bottlenecks in the construction of this great temple? Why are you being instrumental in the being cause of the hurdles in this construction of this temple? This is not only the question of an experienced Vastu expert, but this is also a request as a proud Indian citizen. With the every person who is responsible for taking decision in the construction of this temple, please answer my questions. Answer my questions. Remove the hurdles, remove the thoughts, remove the bottlenecks. Namaskar, I am Achar Kalki Krishnan from astrodevan.com.